a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now.
Okay, Mom, you know what we're doing here, right?
No.
Huh?
No, I don't know what the hell you're doing.
Okay.
You're doing something for the grandchildren.
Yes.
Okay.
This is called the talk for the grandkids.
Oh.
Okay. So, tell me, okay, how'd you get to be, how old are you?
I'm 86 years old.
Oh, yeah. How'd you get to be 86?
Every year I add it on to one. I guess that's how I get to be.
Oh. Okay, but all right. So now you got these grandkids coming up, right?
Yeah.
How do they get to be 86?
Well, each year you add a year.
So if you were like 20,
yeah, the next year I'll be 21, 22, and so forth.
Oh yeah. Okay, well that's pretty good. That's pretty good. What was the name of your horse?
Horse, Pat. Pat, and there was Chop. He was a horse that if you were riding him and you started to fall, he'd stop.
He'd stop?
Yes.
He'd know what to do?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. And so what would you do, like in a snowstorm or whatever? So you have to go to the Polish Draw School, right?
Right.
Okay. And then so you walk there every day?
Yeah.
Or you rode your horse?
No. In the wintertime, we rode a sleigh and a horse.
Okay, so what would happen on those big-ass blizzards?
Whap! Blizzard, yeah, we had blizzard and a lot of snow.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And Polly and I got hit by lightning, but it's a good thing there was a tree that we were walking on the right-hand side instead of the left. If we were working on the left, I wouldn't be here today.
Really?
Well, when lightning strikes you, it kills you.
Yeah. So hang on one second.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, we're still recording. Okay, good. I had to check the camera. Oh. Okay, so what do you mean you're on the right side instead of, you usually walked on the left side?
No, I don't know. We were walking on the right side and the lightning hit the tree.
And where were you going?
To school, and it knocked us both to the ground.
So then what'd you do?
Got up and went to school.
So you got hit by lightning and went to school?
Yeah, but oh, it's really a good thing we were walking on the right side, because if we were walking where the tree got hit, I wouldn't be here.
Really?
Well, no, you'd be dead.
I suppose, eh? Yeah. So what did they teach you? How many kids were at this school?
We were close to 30 kids.
30 kids, all different grades?
All different grades, from grade 1 to grade 8.
And who was the teacher?
Oh, there was a... Oh! What's her name? I'm trying to think of her name. She was married to Joe Bukowski.
And Bukowski was the teacher at the Polish Draw?
Yes, she taught too. And
she taught you?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. That's hard to believe, isn't it?
It is hard to believe.
Yeah, I was trying to... Yeah, she was a school teacher. I remember that. And her parents lived in Edmonton. How she married Joe, I don't know. Why? When she married Joe and how she met him, I guess so, because she was a teacher.
Ah, okay. Right. So... Mom, for these teenagers going to watch this, right? They're going to be growing up. You're going to be in the ground sometime, right?
Oh, yeah. I'll be 6 foot.
So.
Everybody's going to be there one day.
Yeah, exactly. So, what's the secret to life, Mom?
Enjoy life and don't worry.
Really? Don't worry.
Yeah, I found that one out.
How did you find that out?
Well, when you boys were growing up, I used to worry about you. And look, you all grew up real good. So why worry? It doesn't do you any good.
No good to worry.
No, and don't worry.
What else do you need in your life every day?
Huh?
What else do you need in your life every day?
Food.
Okay.
You gotta eat.
Yeah?
Three times a day.
Three times a day.
Right.
What do you have for breakfast?
I usually have toast and coffee. Sometimes I'll have a scrambled egg and coffee.
Oh, yeah. So how do they treat their seniors in Saskatoon?
Oh, that's a nice place to live. They're good to us. We have entertainment twice a month, and we can dance too, which we do.
Yeah.
I dance with Steve, but I also dance with ladies.
Ah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
It's a good place to be.
Yeah. So Steve's your boyfriend?
No, he isn't.
You're going to get married to him, right?
No, I am not.
Any money?
No way am I getting married again.
Why not?
Why should I? Then I have to cook, and I can't. Sometimes I can't go where I want to do what I want. This way I do what I want, and I'm enjoying life.
Uh-huh.
I come to see you guys. I've traveled the world. I was overseas for 3 weeks, and I traveled a lot. So there.
So really, a man would just tie you down.
Huh?
A man would just tie you down.
That's right. Some men maybe wouldn't want to travel.
Yeah.
This way, I did what I wanted.
Really? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, that's good.
Yeah.
So lots of men come knocking on the door, though, right?
No. Huh? No men come knocking. Steve sometimes come knocking at a door because he one time, I was over there to give him a pie. And here he gave me made me sup a lunch.
He made you lunch?
Yeah.
You took him a pie. What kind of pie do you make?
Oh, I make lemon pie, lemon pie, apple pie, and rhubarb and strawberry pie.
Yeah, yeah.
Did I mention that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, and like, how many pies have you made in your life?
Oh, I would say at least a million. Well, wherever I was, I made pies, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, you always made pies. When did you start making pies? Did you make pies when you're on the farm?
Yes, I did, because you know what? We had an apple tree, and I...
On the farm?
Yes. And I tell you, oh God, I made more apple pie than I want to even think about.
So you go pick the apples, clean them up, and make your apple pies.
That's right.
Right on the farm for the
right
men.
Right on the farm.
Really? Huh? So when the men were out working, what would the women do?
Well, the women would have to clean the house, wash the floor, make breakfast, dinner, and supper for the men.
Yeah. Yeah. Like when they're out in the field, what would you do? Because they'd be out in horses out harvesting, right?
Oh, yeah. Dad had 21 horses and a stallion.
21 horses?
I have a picture of that.
Really? And how did he get 21 horses?
I guess he bought them.
Yeah, where did he get the money from?
A bootlegging.
So the old guy was a bootlegger.
Yeah.
And how did all that happen?
Well, I don't know, but he knew Al Capone.
He knew Al Capone.
That's right.
Really?
And you know what? When the Al Capone's men came to the farm, us children could not go outside. And I just found out recently why, because they'd have machine guns and other guns, and they would shoot them in the air.
Shoot at each other.
No, nobody was ever killed.
But nobody was killed?
Nobody was killed. But how Dad met Al Capone, I haven't got a clue.
Well, he was from Chicago originally.
Yeah.
That's where he grew up.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, maybe that's...
So every winter, Joe, he'd head down south for 3 weeks, right?
That's right.
How would your mom feel about that?
I tell you, mom got the biggest surprise in her life.
Why? What happened?
Well, she didn't know he was married twice. And one time, two guys came to work for dad, you know? And of course, they just told their first name. They didn't tell their last name and their name. That was his two sons.
So, and then what did he do? What did he do when he found out his two sons came?
He brought them into they could sleep in the house instead of the bunkhouse. Well, that's the truth.
You know what they'd call old Joe today, right?
Huh?
You know what they'd call Joe today, right? They'd call him a gangster. You think he was a gangster?
Who?
Joe, your dad.
Well, I don't know if he was or not.
Sounds like a gangster to me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you know, they used to make homebrew.
Yeah.
And you know why my dad never got caught? Huh. He dug a hole beside, see, because we had a lot of trees on the farm.
Okay.
So he'd dig a hole and put it in there. Well, it was pure alcohol.
Yeah. Yeah.
Joe Bukowski, one time I went to visit him, he says, Vi.
That's your brother, Joe.
My brother, Joe. Yeah. And he says to me, how would you like to taste some homebrew? I says, are you crazy? I don't want to taste that. He says, never mind. I says, okay, give me a wee little bit. I don't know how those men drank it. I tasted a little bit of it.
Yeah.
Because I knew better.
Did you get all boozed up or what?
Oh, I just took a wee little sip, but I don't know how the heck those guys drank that homebrew.
So you think there's a bunch of money buried out at the farm there somewhere that he forgot about, got drunk, and because he used to sample his own supply, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So how long would you kids have to stay in the house when
As long as the men were there.
How long would that be? A day? Oh, an
all
hour?
Day.
All day?
Yeah, but they never got killed.
That was just luck, wasn't it? They're out there drinking and shooting guns off?
Jesus, yes, and shooting up in the air. It's a good thing they're shooting up the air, but nobody got killed.
Nobody got killed?
No.
That you know of?
No.
There was no windows on the north side of the house.
No.
Yeah. Well, what do you think about these bloody Bukowskis now took over the farmhouse?
Who, Brian and Jen?
Yeah.
Oh, I think that was pretty nice, but you know what Brian told me?
What?
He says it would have been cheaper for him to buy a house or...
Just build a house there. Yeah. Yeah, instead of fixing up that old one.
Oh, yeah. But they fixed it up very nice.
Oh, yeah, it's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
So that's nice.
Yeah, and then we go there July the 1st. But the funniest part, I always took lemon pies.
Yeah.
But one year I thought, that's enough of the lemon pie. So I made spare ribs. And one guy comes up and he says, where's your lemon pie?
So everybody's looking for your lemon pie.
Yeah. They all liked it, I guess.
I guess, yeah.
Yeah, because I put two lemons and a lime in it.
Yeah.
Rod told me one time he went to his mother-in-law's place for to have supper, and he says, she says, I got lemon pie. He says, I didn't know I was eating lemon pie. Well,
you're used to the good.
Well, you gotta put a nice, a great lemon.
Yeah.
And then you squeeze them and you good. And Diane is the one that told me to use a lime.
Use a lime?
Yeah.
How did that go?
Good.
Yeah? It's good in a pie? Yeah. Do you grate the lime too? Or do you
No.
No, you just grate the lemon.
Just the lemon. But there's sometimes you get lemons, you can't grate them. I don't know why.
They're just too hard, or
who knows,
eh? Yeah.
But that's what I
used. So what else did you do on the farm? Did you ever go out and stook, make the stooks out in the field, or
not? The men did that.
The men did that. So they how long a day would they put in?
Okay.
We're back. We're live with G-Ma.
Huh?
We're live with G-Ma. Okay.
What's G-Ma?
Grandma.
G-Ma.
It's Grandma. G for grandma. How do you spell grandma?
Grandma.
G.
Yeah, and M.
So it's G-ma.
Oh, you forgot the...
Okay, so, all right. Now, here's what we want to know. Okay.
Do you think I can tell you?
I don't know. You think you can?
Oh, I'll try.
Okay. So, tell me about when you got electricity on the farm. Did you use, like, you didn't have electricity at some time, right?
Right, but we did.
So, how did you get the internet if you didn't have electricity?
We had, Jesus, you should have seen the batteries that were there to get the lights in the house.
Ooh. Really?
Oh, yeah, there must have been. Oh, I couldn't even tell you how many batteries we had.
You had batteries for the lights?
That's right. How else could you have lights in the power one and you didn't have Yeah?
Okay, so you didn't have electricity at some point, right?
Right.
Yeah, and then you got electricity.
Yeah.
Okay. So what would happen before you got electricity? What would you use for a fridge?
You had to put milk down the well, cream down the well, butter down the well. And I'll tell you another funny thing. They had to make butter, I think that it was a round barrel, and you'd go like this. But you had to remember to halfway, or whenever you thought of it, take the little thing out so it wouldn't shoot up. If you didn't, then it'd shoot up and the milk would go. Yeah.
And that's how you made your own butter.
Yeah.
And you made your own, we milked the cows or what?
I didn't have to.
You didn't have to, but they milked the cows.
Oh yeah, Mom, Mel and Lucy milked the cows. So I had to feed the chickens.
You fed the chickens.
And gather the eggs.
And how did you pay the doctor? If the doctor had to come.
Well, I don't
know. You give him chickens or what?
He always took, before he went home, whoever got sick, the man would drive him, because of course he didn't know where to go.
Oh, okay.
And then he'd come back, stop at mother's, and take the loaf of bread, homemade bread, every time, never missed.
Do you remember who the doctor was?
Eagle Sham. Yeah. There was three, and I went with a boy named Eagle Sham, and he became the third doctor. There was three.
And you went out with him?
No, I didn't go out with
him.
But he was in my grade.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's interesting. So, when you were a kid, how did you get the internet?
We didn't have no internet.
No internet?
Well, no.
You didn't have electricity?
Well, yes, we did have power. But
later.
When did we get the power? But you should have seen the batteries to have the power. Oh, Mom.
Is that right?
Oh, Jesus, it filled this room up practically.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So, if somebody's got a sore throat, what do they got to do?
Gargle it with salt. That's the best thing there is.
The kids?
Kids and out.
Everybody?
Everybody. You got a sore throat, get some hot water, put a teaspoon of salt in it, and then gargle.
Ah.
And you got rid of your of the sore throat.
And you, okay, so you don't eat much, right?
Now?
Yeah.
No, I don't. Because, well, what do I do?
I don't know. What do you do?
Make three meals a day.
Yeah.
And I got a little rug where I don't use the broom anymore, so it's nothing to do. And I got another machine. I pour this much water in it and I wash my floor. That's it.
Ah.
That's pretty neat.
Because every time you come here, you eat like a horse.
Yeah, I know I eat like a horse. So you told me that long ago. You crazy bugger.
So, Mama, tell me the story about Bill when he came home and he sat you on his knee.
Oh, God, I've never heard a man cry. That was after Billy was killed, you see.
Okay.
And he set me on his knee, and I've never heard anybody cry as hard. Well, here I was thanking God. I thought he got over it.
Yeah.
He never did.
Never did get over it.
Well, that was his own son, you see.
Yeah.
And he blamed himself. See, Billy was standing, and he was driving the tractor.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, Billy started to fall, and he went to reach for him, and his foot slipped off the clutch, and that's when he went under.
Oh, really? My God.
And then he had to drive, about 10, 12 miles to bring him home. And I remember he even brought the priest over. I don't know why he brought the priest. And I, as soon as I saw the priest, I knew something was wrong.
Wow.
That was sad. And Billy was so good with the kids and the children. And at the funeral, all the whole school came to the funeral. They sat on the sides.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
I never knew that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. They all sat. But they sat on the side pews. You know. The whole school came. But you know, Billy was such a good kid. The kids were fighting.
He'd go straighten them out.
He'd straighten them out. You know, that was funny. I never had to. Yeah, he was a nice kid. But, well, actually, and I told Bill, I don't, you know, want to blame him, but I said, look, it was an accident. I said, I do not blame you.
Uh-huh.
But I've never heard anybody cry so hard in my life. I thought that would do it, but it didn't. Well, it was his own, and when Billy was born, I never saw a happier man.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah. He was just top of the world.
Oh, my God.
And then this happened, but accidents happen. And I talked to him. I said, look, I don't blame you. I said, it was an accident, but...
Never got over it, eh?
He never. But though he drank, he still was a good husband.
Yeah.
Some husbands, they start drinking and beating up their wife. I don't know what the hell for.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I mean, just stop and think what the wife does for him.
Yeah.
Well, that's the way it goes.
Yeah. Yeah. This life is hard, eh?
Yeah, that was sad. About a blame him or something, but I talked to him and talked to him.
No.
But I've never heard anybody cry as hard as he did. He sat me on his knee, and I thought, here I was thanking God, I thought he'd get over it.
Yeah, yeah.
No.
Never happened, eh?
No, it never happened. Because, see, that was his son. But when Billy was born, I never seen a happier man.
Is that right, eh?
Well, yeah. He was just so happy.
Seventh heaven.
Yeah.
So he was, what did he do in the Air Force? What was he?
He was a gunner.
Gunner.
Shooting the planes down?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
But did he actually go to war? Or did he stay here? What, did he train or?
Yeah, he was trained. He was, I think they were overseas for the training.
Ah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, that's what you call life. I would say, that's what you call life.
That's what you call life, eh?
We're all gonna die sometimes.
Just a question of how you get there, eh, Mom?
But thank God I don't know when I'm gonna. I don't want to know. Just I hope I'm just dropped dead and that'll be. But look at the health I got.
Oh, I know. Jeez. Yeah, it's great.
I haven't got an ache. I haven't got a pain. Now that's pretty wonderful.
I think we still got battery too, Mom.
Well, I hope so. I hope you're not going to call me again.
Yeah, how many times can we do this interview?
Well,
you got to remember all this stuff.
I might forget something. Oh, Doreen, she's completely out of it.
Really? Yeah.
Well, she got Alzheimer's. Well, you know, Don was getting Alzheimer's.
Yeah.
Too. I told when Robert came home, I got to go, I'll tell him, oh no, he hasn't got all tired. You know, he's just getting forgetful. I never said a word.
Yeah.
But then they found out Harry. Harry took his dad home, and I think that's what he found out for sure.
Yeah.
See, he, but he wrote on he. We were something place, and he wrote on the slip, "Vi, you left the water running in the bathroom." Well, I know who dealt with that.
But you had good husbands.
Oh,
you had two good husbands.
I can't complain. Yeah. Yeah, they were really good to me. So.
And now you're going to marry Steve, that millionaire, so
no,
leave us
I
a few
not,
bucks, eh?
Forget it. I don't care. He was a millionaire. You know, there was a lady that married a millionaire, and that was the worst husband.
Really?
For giving her money.
Oh! Well, that's maybe how he made his $1 million.
Could be, I don't know.
Yeah, he didn't give anybody any.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. That was funny, I thought. What the hell are you going to do with $1 million in your life? How are you going to
I don't
spend?
Know, what are you going to do with the lottery when you win it?
Oh! You might get some if you're good to me.
I'd have to be pretty good.
I tell you what, if I ever win, I'll divide it against with the 9 grandchildren and the 4 sons.
Yeah, that would
and
be.
I don't
it,
want
eh?
Any money.
No.
I got enough.
What do you got? What do you got money? What do you need money for?
Eating.
Eating. That's it.
Rent.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're covered.
Yeah.
I and even know. Mike that. He'll have you over for supper, but you gotta make pies.
Oh, don't mention pies to me. I must have made 1 million pies in my life. Oh, you know, I never I didn't mind making them, but I was giving them back. What the hell?
Yeah. Give them hell, eh, Mom?
Well, sure. And that was funny. Valerie and Robert at my place, and we were sitting talking, and he thought, oh, we better go home, so he went. And I thought, oh my God, I forgot the pie. So
what?
I ran like hell to see him, but he was gone. In the meantime, he came back for the pie, but he never got it because I wasn't at home. But I said, the next time anybody comes for a pie, I'll write pie right on the door. Then they won't forget it.
Yeah, well, you come down here from Saskatoon. Where's my bloody pies?
You never asked me for it. Where's your lemons? Where's your limes?
Oh, I'm going to have to talk to that head cook here.
Last time I made you 5 pies, remember that?
Yeah. Oh yeah, those were good.
You got it out, but you order in.
Yeah, I guess.
I made enough pies to last me a lifetime.
Actually, there is lemons. I don't think there's any graham wafers, though.
Is there? Have you got lemons?
I got lemons, but no graham wafers.
Oh.
Bummer, yeah. Eh, Mom?
You need graham wafers.
Yeah.
See? Well, you should have had that all lined up. You
Jeez,
knew I was coming.
I didn't,
what's the matter with you?
Yeah, I'm not organized. So what else would you do on the farm, Mom? What did you do for fun on the farm?
Singing. And on Sunday, everybody came to our place and we sang like crazy. That's why I know all the old songs.
Ah, yeah.
But you know, there was a neighbor. He'd come and borrow something from Dad. But he never brought it back, so his dad used to go over there and tell him, look, I want this back. It's not yours, and he got it.
Your dad was quite the character.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
How did he meet Al Capone? That I would like to
Well, know. He was born in Chicago.
Oh.
That's where Al Capone is from.
Oh, well, then that's how they met.
I guess. So, but Grandpa would take off every February for 3 weeks.
January, February, March, for 3 weeks and see Al Capone.
You think he went down there and saw Al Capone?
Well, sure. You know what those buggers did. Drank, what? Had women, and then had a hell of a good time. That's all I can think of. I don't know what they did.
you think they were down there?
Well, that's what I figured it out.
Oh, yeah. You figured they were down there with women.
Well, why not?
I guess, eh? You're
nobody would know. Because.
And then he had 10 kids in the States.
Huh?
He had 10 kids down in the States.
Did he have 10?
10 before he came up.
I did not think. I know there was 4 men and a lady.
No, he had 10 altogether.
Is that right?
Yeah. Huh. Oh, well.
Whatever.
He was a character.
But I tell you, Mom got the biggest surprise of her life.
Oh, I'll bet you.
Jesus.
Huh?
See, these two guys came for work. They were his sons, and he didn't recognize them. They just told him the first name. And then he went to the, about 2-3 days, he went later and found they were registered at Bukowski.
Oh, boy.
So then he brought him home to the, instead of sleeping in the bunk bed, he brought him to the house. Of course, he had to come. Yeah, she must have got a big surprise. Well, I guess she did.
I guess.
Holy God.
How did she take that?
I don't know.
Don't know, eh?
Well, she had to take it.
Yeah, I guess. So did they talk to each other?
Who?
Your mom and your dad.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. See, Dad was quite a bit older than Mom.
Yeah. You old bugger.
I said, we got quite a history. Well, you've seen that history I wrote.
Yeah.
I know there was 4, Charlie and Curly. Curly was a barber. What the other guys did, I don't know. And I knew that there was a lady. I thought he had only 5. I don't know.
Oh, I don't know. Yeah.
Ah, what the
whatever. Place. It's all water under the bridge now.
But
eh?
You know what? Yeah, I've heard... Lona got me a book on Al Capone, and when he knew there were people starving, he'd give them money.
Well, you just like a...
That's pretty good.
Yeah, I guess. Just kind of an honest thief.
Oh, and Dad never, I told you that before, Dad never got caught with homebrew.
Yeah, you bury it all. You think there's money buried out there?
Oh, no, I don't.
Any booze buried out there I could go dig up and have a few drinks?
You might find one if he missed one. Yeah, that's where he hit his. You know, when they caught him with homebrew, they got fined.
Oh,
Dad
yeah.
never got fined. They were all dug by the. Well, look at the trees we had on the farm.
Yeah, he was too sneaky.
Wouldn't it be fun to find one?
Oh, yeah.
And I had a taste of homebrew.
Yeah, you're saying.
I knew them well. I had enough brains to just have a
little sip.
When Joe Bocasti told me, I says, are you crazy?
Yeah.
Because I knew damn well that was pure alcohol.
Yeah, really, eh?
Yeah, honest to people. We got quite a history. I bet you nobody has a history like we
have. Well, yeah, it's a pretty unique history, that's for sure, Mama.
And when that was in the... I guess it was in the Regina paper too about if Al Capone was in Saskatchewan. And then that little article where he knew a farmer about 10 miles north of Weyburn. Of course, that was Dad. And you know why we couldn't play outside? I just found out that. They were drinking and shooting up in the air, but they never killed anybody.
Oh, that's good.
Jeez.
So they put their cars out in the barn.
Oh, yeah.
And the outbuildings.
And Dad built, you know, because he did come during the day and overnight. And I was telling that to Don, he started laughing. He says, I saw those cars going across. They went, of course, not... where they're supposed to.
Oh, yeah. They'd run the border.
That's right.
Yeah.
I says, we got quite a history.
Yeah, that's for sure.
God.
Yeah.
But I know there was Charlie, Curly. I used to know all the boys' names.
Yeah.
There's five boys I know.
Frank?
And one
was there
lady.
Frank? Was there a Frank?
Yeah, there was a Frank. That's right. Oh, God. We got quite a history. I know, I sometimes just have to laugh.
Yeah, well, what can you do, Mom?
What can you do? It happened.
So all your brothers and sisters are gone.
Yeah.
You're the last one.
I'm the last one of the Mohegan. When I die, that will be it.
That'll be it.
But I don't worry when I die. When the time comes, you die. Why worry, Mom?
Yeah, I guess.
No. I just hope I drop dead or fall or die.
You're pretty healthy. I mean, you walk around and you you look good. And
oh, I like.
How old are you?
86. That's 86. All.
86.
Jesus, I hope I don't live too long. Oh well, we don't know when we're gonna die, so that's one thing that is great.
Yeah. So any of the angels or anything ever come around and chit-chat with you? Or
angels?
Yeah, or Jesus or anything?
No.
They haven't talked to you yet?
No.
Let you know anything?
No, they wouldn't let me know anything. You're crazy about me. Life is what you make it. That's the way I look at it. I always enjoyed my life.
Yeah. Good.
And but when you kids were growing up, Jesus, I used to worry about not that. That's the stupid thing a person can do is sit and worry.
Yeah.
What will happen, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Well.
Yeah.
Oh well.
Oh, you had a good life, Mom.
Oh, I sure did, and I had two good husbands. So what the hell?
And you still got a bunch more to. You still got some more kicking around in you. Huh? You're going good.
Well, I don't know.
Huh?
I got damn good health. I haven't got a shake. I haven't got a pain. And I feel great. My memory is still...
Not bad, eh?
Not bad.
Yeah, we talked about a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's when your mind goes. That's I wish I'd just whoop, drop.
Boom.
Like Doreen. Jesus, she's gonna... Well... She couldn't help it. She got it.
Yeah.
But, you know, I wonder if I got to, I'm going to, when I get home, I'm going to read down the paper something about Alzheimer's. Coffee is supposed to be good and something else.
Hmm.
They said 2-3 cups of coffee a day. And something else. Ah.
Oh, well. What the hell? So what else you got to say? You just enjoy your life.
Enjoy your life and don't worry.
Enjoy your life, don't worry.
That's right.
That sounds like some good advice, eh?
Oh, God, when you kids were growing up, I guess you can't help worrying, but if I don't know that I would... So I said to anybody, I said, enjoy your life and don't worry.
Okay.
That's it.
All right. What else you got to say, Mama?
Well, there's nothing much.
Yeah.
But I didn't know this about Al Capone, that he'd give money to people.
You're just like a saint, Mom.
Yeah. So, but Mom must have got a big shock.
Yeah. Okay, Mama. Thank you very much for taking some time and chit-chatting.
Chit-chat.
Yeah, I'm going to check this and make sure that we got it this time.
Well, you better have it because I quit talking to you. did you empty the dishwasher?
Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, don't do it. Be happy. Put a smile on your face. Don't bring everybody down like this. Don't worry. It will soon pass, whatever it is. Don't worry. Be happy. not worried. I'm happy.